Hey guys, what's up? I know it's been a little while since I've done a cooking with Kengi video, and I'm working on a project that I've been working on for a little over a year now, and I'm just starting to develop the project and get it all put together, and I'll be making an announcement about that project pretty soon. Actually, I'll just make it now. I'm doing a Cooking with Kengi cookbook. It's all my favorite recipes, plus some recipes from my friends, some family recipes, and it's going to be in a cookbook that I hope to have ready, hopefully in a couple of months. So that's it. But today, I have a friend that's just like, hey, I want some enchiladas. Could you please make some enchiladas? Yada, yada, yada. So I was like, you know what? I can make some enchiladas. So today on Cooking with Kengi, we're gonna make some enchiladas my way.
Back hey in a guys, second. What's up? So I already have my ground beef completely done in my skillet here, and all I did was brown it, add a little bit of salt and pepper, a little bit of chili powder, some garlic, which you see right there. And some onions browned it. I'm letting it cool. Now in this skillet here, I have a little bit of canola oil, and all I'm basically gonna be doing, let me turn the skillet back on. It was on a second ago. All I'm basically going to be doing is dipping my tortillas into the oil, and I'm not frying the tortillas. I'm just making the tortillas pliable so I can roll them without them cracking. Some people warm them up over the open flame. I don't do that. The person that showed me how to make enchiladas a very long time ago, a Latina, showed me this technique, and I've stuck with this technique. That's it. I'm gonna take it out. Set it right there and continue this process, and I'll be back in a second to show you how I roll. So I'm going to show you the process, and then my pan is actually back there where I'm going to put the enchiladas, and I promise I will show you what they look like once they're in the pan. Now this first shell is it broke. This is my own enchilada sauce here. I made it myself. I will put the recipe on my blog. It is super easy, super quick. You do not even have to be a cook or whatever. This is really, really simple, really, really easy. Once again, it is a recipe given to me a long time ago by one of my Latina friends. So it's something that I use all the time. If I don't use this, then I do use the canned enchilada sauce, and I do use the Rosarita. But today I made my own. You can check my blog for the recipe on the sauce. So the shells are all done, totally pliable. So I'm gonna do like this and get this all ready. And then I'm just gonna put some meat in here, and I'm gonna roll it just like so. And I'm gonna place it seam side down in the dish. And I'm just gonna continue doing this until I have them all filled up. I usually don't put cheese inside because I usually load it with cheese on the outside. If I'm making like a vegetarian enchilada, I will sometimes do like a cheese enchilada, or I've also done potato enchiladas for my vegetarian friends. I also have used the meatless soy for my vegetarian friends, and they really, really like that. And I've actually used the meatless soy, and just not told my friends who are meat eaters, and they could not taste the difference. So I'm gonna continue doing this, and then I will be back to show you guys what they look like once I get them all into the pan. Well, before I go, you can do this with ground beef. I've done it with shredded pork. I've also done it with shredded chicken. Somebody told me they did it with ground chicken and ground turkey, and I'm sure that tastes great. I've never used ground turkey or ground chicken before, at least not in enchiladas, but I'm sure it tastes fantastic.
Here's the finished product. The enchiladas are in the pan. Some people put their enchiladas in the pan and they pack them in, and then once you put the cheese on them, it just looks like lasagna or a no-roll enchilada. I try to not pack mine in. And if it was just me and a couple of friends, I wouldn't actually put the enchiladas into the oven to melt the cheese. I would go with the meat would already be hot. I would prepare and cook my enchilada sauce, and then I would roll my enchiladas and put them directly into the pan where my sauce is, get them back up to temperature, pull them out, put cheese on them, whatever my garnish is, and then that. But because I'm showing you guys, and I do have some other things to do, and I have some friends that are coming over, I do it this way. I know a lot of people do it this way. So what I'm gonna do is, let's just hit these babies with some cheese. Sorry for kicking you. I couldn't find any Mexican cheese, the queso fresco. I couldn't find that. So I am using a cheese from Trader Joe's, which is a shredded, they call it a Mexican blend. I don't know how true that is, but that's what they call it. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of cheese over these. Not too much. Okay guys, these are out of the oven. They are looking spectacular. They smell so good. I wish you guys could have smell-o-vision so you can smell this. I've got my sauce that's getting piping hot right here. Once again, for the full recipe, check my blog. I will put a link in the description. Over here, I have a really simple guacamole that I made. It is simply one large avocado, some Roma tomatoes, actually one Roma tomato, garlic, because I love garlic, and chopped onions, and just a lemon wedge to protect it, some salt and pepper, and that's it. I'm gonna plate these babies up just like so. I'm gonna take the one that was beaten up and I'm gonna hit these babies just once again with the sauce. Sauce is so scrumptious. Like I said, if I had the queso fresco cheese, I would use that, but I don't. Just a little bit more cheese over the top.
I'm gonna hit it with some green onions. And lastly, some sliced olives, some sliced black olives. Some people don't like sliced blacks, but I do. There's that. I'll put a little bit of sour cream and a little bit of guacamole on the plate with some chips and salsa, some black beans. We're gonna call this baby done. Happy eating, everybody. Thanks for watching. I want to say big thanks to everybody who has supported my latest project, which is Project KengiKat and the Do Something Saturday book. Thank you so much for purchasing the book. I really, really appreciate it. I don't know if you guys have seen my kitchen since it's been remodeled. I don't know if I put that video up or not, but I got a new stove, new countertops, new cabinets, even got cabinets above my sink, everything. And like I said before, if you guys are really, really good, you will wash your dishes as you go so you can enjoy your guests. Bon appetit, everybody. This has been Cooking with Kengi. I will put a link to the blog downstairs. Feel free to check it out. Peace and blessings. We'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye. Anybody who eats at my place knows that I love tequila and I love a good vodka. My favorite vodka is Hangar One. It is brewed up in the Bay Area. It goes down so smooth. It is just like water, and it's very, very dangerous because before you know it, you've had six drinks. You're not feeling a thing, so you got to be careful with that. Another vodka that is now on my list of favorites. A friend actually just bought this bottle a few nights ago, and it is called Summum. That is, or Summum, whatever. It is S-U-M-M-U-M, Summum vodka. It is from France. Again, so smooth, so refreshing. You got to be very, very careful. I love tequila. Usually when I'm at home, if my girl Natalie is here, then it's tequila and squirt, or we'll improvise and do a couple things. Whoops, didn't mean to do that. What did I do? Okay, so we're going to put some vodka in this shaker, just a little bit. And this is basic. This is a very, that's enough. This is a very basic drink. Nothing special, not a whole lot of stuff. This is just Trader Joe's pink lemonade. We're gonna get the top on this. Give this baby a shake. Get it all mixed up. Shake, 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 shake. Shake, 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 shake. And then into the glass it goes. Refreshing, yummy. You guys should check this out. Hangar One is by far the best. You probably got to get it at a better... you can't just walk into some liquor store and get Hangar One. It is at a better liquor dispenser, seller, distributor, whatever you want to call it. And I'm not sure where she got this. If I'm not mistaken, she got it at BevMo, and the beverage manager told her about it. It is great. So Hangar One and Summum. Peace. Bon appetit.